It's Diwali time, and the good news is there are some signs of a revival in the economy. Exports have surged for the September quarter, and more importantly, even the IIP numbers are looking up. The bad news, however, is that the consumer sentiment is low and industry is reluctant to invest. To get a glimpse of the ground situation, I am joined by Mr. Anil Agarwal, the chairman of the Vedanta Group. Mr. Agarwal, welcome to ET Now.
Thank you very much.
The Indian economy has been in focus lately with the RBI and the IMF scaling down the growth projections. What's your take? Is the worst behind us?
Definitely. It's not the question of worst. We are going through the process. You know, the intention of the government is absolutely never been anything negative. They always wanted country to grow and to remain prosperous, and it is a process, and I have no doubt time to come is going to be one of the best country as far as 1.3 billion people, where else you will find.
But where does this optimism come from? Because if I look at the credit growth, it is at a record low and investment cycle is not showing any signs of a pickup.
See, this country, you have to understand the DNA. This country is the country for the entrepreneur. It's not the country as a communist. It's a democracy. And if you see the democracy DNA, look at the America. It's about the creating the huge movement. And we have to understand the country has grown because of the entrepreneur.
Absolutely.
A tremendous, and that what is being boosted, and I'm looking forward because they don't have, they are not warrior. You know, they want two things. They want government support and public support.
And decent return for the investments also.
Decent, but they will take risk. They will take risk. Out of 10, if 5 fail, it's fine. But that's how the job will be created. That's how the, you know, economy will revive. That's how the eradicating of poverty will take place.
But why is industry so reluctant to invest? Is it the huge idle capacities that are lying around? Or do you think the high interest rates are also at work?
No, everything has making a difference. But the fundamental is the wait and watch, I think.
But this wait and watch mode is going on for a very long time.
Yeah, but you know, the government has a great intention. This government, where else you will find government like this, where 2/3 of majority. And this government has only one intention, to take the country forward. And probably there is a timing was mismatch, maybe. I feel I can talk about my subject. I love my country. I love my country no matter where I live. I work for my country. I always think, what can I contribute to my country? And I am very bullish. And whatever happened last 30 years.
But why is that bullishness not there with other industrialists? Because we are not seeing the kind of money coming to the ground. And at the end of the day, the onus cannot be just on the government, right?
I fully agree. I mean, the government, what they talk about is the ease of doing business. You know, what they talk about, how they look at the business people. It's very important. This government was definitely looking to clean the government, clean the system.
Absolutely.
And that will help in the long run. There is no question. But I think the mood is coming. The mood is definitely coming. Everybody was on the fence. The lot of foreign investment, if you see, the stock market is fueling, the atmosphere being created. I can talk about my area. I have a feel that we are right at the stage where we have to take off.
No, we'll come to your businesses in a while, but the point is, while the stock market has been rallying big time, but if I turn to the shopping malls during Diwali, I don't see the kind of crowd that I normally used to see. I mean, obviously, there is something wrong with the consumer confidence right now. I mean, people are not making discretionary spends. How to revive that?
You know, I see great future for the time being. There may be some lullness, but I don't foresee any reason why this country will not grow. This may be people, what I read in the newspaper, what you read, what I read, the GST to be sorted out, you know, demonetization, whatever was the effect, it is a long run going to be great benefit, but there may be a very short time, something what you feel, I feel, but I'm only looking the future.
We are also hoping that the slowdown is short term, but the bigger worry is jobless growth. We are not creating the kind of jobs that a country like India needs. I mean, what is your suggestion to the government on that?
No, I'm too small to suggest anything big, but I definitely tremendous potential in this country. You know, the manufacturing, we live in Bihar, Bengal, and we have grown with the manufacturing. You know, we have seen Bokaro, we have seen Sindri, we have seen Tata Nagar, we have seen all these places because of the manufacturing. The whole city, the whole atmosphere was to was the part of it. So I'm looking forward the tremendous potential. You know, you look at the business, you're looking the business of telecom, you're looking the business of IT, startup, innovation, technology, which is happening. All India has a tremendous part of it. We come to the manufacturing. We come to the manufacturing. In the manufacturing, what we talk about, I can only talk about the tremendous potential the country has. As you know, we produce auspicious metal. We produce gold. We have a tremendous reserve of gold.
In fact, that's the reason why, obviously, I would also want to talk about the IIP numbers. IIP numbers, we have seen a spurt. I mean, there are signs that things are looking better, and that's what the recent IIP numbers suggest. I mean, do you think it's the beginning of the end when it comes to the gloom and doom that everybody was worrying about?
I fully agree with you. There is no question. You will watch what going to happen this year, because the platform has been created, thing will take off.
Because Mr. Agarwal, you understand the ground realities better than most people. I mean, what is your take? I mean, is it the fact that demonetization, the kind of glitches that we saw with GST, that is what is resulting in the pain that we are facing right now?
I'm not authority, but that's what I hear. But this has a long-term positive effect. That's what I also feel. The GST and demonetization will have a very long-term effect in the country in a positive way.
And especially once the GST glitches are ironed out, obviously the government has been very proactive when it comes to dealing with them. That should lead to some sort of a normalcy returning.
I fully agree. I never seen government to be so proactive. You see, the government has acted very quickly. They have, in even the days, they are looking how to streamline, how to stabilize the GST, and that's you can see obviously things are taking shape.
But I mean, for example, while we were discussing, there were quite a few weaknesses in the economy which are apparent on the face of it. But if I turn to the stock markets, there is festival going on. I mean, the point is the rally driven by fundamentals, you think?
See, it's a fundamental thing, because people believe in the country. People have certain allocation to put in money into India, and they find the very limited stock. So people put in the money, and that what fuel. And as you are seeing, the real growth when will take place, thing will stabilize again.
In fact, the kind of experience you have, I mean, what would be the top three focal points when it comes to reviving the economy from the stage we are in today? Because very clearly, and the government also admits that things need to be done now. What are the top two, three things that the government you think should focus on?
First and foremost, the tremendous trust in Indian entrepreneurs.
Absolutely.
And power of ignorance. You cannot pinpoint them, make a policy. There will be a greed. Let's make a policy very open. We are very concerned about only one thing, which is our environment. Let's make a policy that we want to keep our air as clean as possible in the world. We don't want any discharge. Encourage them, whether providing them the loan, going to the stock market, government policies, allotting the land, whatever is necessary. Let's go full hog. Number two, I can talk about my subject, which is India has tremendous oil and gas, 70 billion barrel of resources of oil, which no other country has.
We'll come to the oil question, yeah, because you, yeah, recently met with the Prime Minister,
yes,
also to,
yes,
discuss how to make India self-sufficient when it comes to the oil needs. But I mean, I would also want to get your views on the kind of reforms that the government has initiated. I mean, government has done quite a bit actually in the last 3 years. But more importantly, I mean, GST has been a landmark reform. There are glitches. But if I look at something in your field, I mean, when it comes to opening up commercial mining, I mean, the CCA is already aware of that. They are looking at methodology, how to allocate coal blocks. Would Vedanta be interested in something like that?
We have to learn with what we have done. They have done the iron ore mining auction. They have done coal mining auction. But I can tell you, the auction has gone at the price up to 90% revenue sharing. You know, this is non-starter. We are, as a government, we are not interested in making money. What we want, more production. What we want, more job to be created. That should be the fundamental in our mind. You know, making money should not be a sin.
Absolutely.
So, I'm definitely interested, but the whole thing is the mindset should be, I sometimes feel the government should put a cap that we cannot have more than 40% revenue sharing.
I mean, turning to your core sectors, metal mining, we have seen a dream run lately. I mean, do you see that? Is it sustainable?
These prices has to be there. There is no new mining is opening in the world. There is no new well being opened up. And I feel that this is the correct price, and I still feel that there should be another 10 to 15% further price will increase. 10 to 15%. But these are the realistic price, and I believe that this price are important, and this price will be there.
If I turn to oil and gas, I mean, you are betting very big on that. In fact, a big chunk of your $6 billion investments will be focused to the oil and gas sector. What makes you so bullish? I mean, because there is a talk, many people are worried that maybe the oil prices will fall in the coming days. I mean, what makes you bullish that things are not going to look bad at all?
We have made like this all my last 20 years. We have always taken a challenge, always kept the country in middle. If somebody has to come forward, somebody has to come forward. We can't remain importing 85% of oil. Everybody comes to India, talk about refinery and petrochemical. How about our own oil, which is in the ground? So I have taken that challenge, and I'm really very, very determined and bullish.
In fact, what has been your suggestion? I mean, you met the Prime Minister recently along with other oil producers. I mean, how to make India self-reliant when it comes to its energy needs?
Don't look at how much money they're making. It's not relevant. It's not relevant. I get revenue, 80% I'm giving to the government. 80%. Nowhere in the world. And still government say, give me 10% more. Is that's what should be the intention? Their intention should be, no matter Anil, produce more. As long as you kept up, you are not taking any subsidy from us, you are not taking any assistance from us. What you are saying that I am taking a challenge to double the production. Encourage me. Now I am producing the oil, I am selling at 15% discount than the international price. My heart breaks. How anybody will invest in India?
Unless you get the right price.
Yeah. Right price. And leave this thing, whether export, non-export, does not matter. Produce. Take the oil from the ground. Two things. Get the oil from the ground and keep our environment intact. And resolve things, not moving the file for months in the department. Take the decision right in there. There is nothing.
Absolutely. I mean, if I turn to your power and iron ore business, I mean, it's been a little slow, uneventful. I mean, what are the plans you have going forward?
No, tremendous. What a country we have. You know, it is better than Australia. We can produce 700-800 million ton of iron ore. Our Prime Minister, how he dream? He talk about producing 300 million ton of steel. That will change the country. You need, today we have a cap on iron ore. Let the big boys come, let them open up, it's required billions of dollars. Iron ore is right there on the surface, in the best of quality. Only thing, government has to keep very simple, and if the people are bidding, 90% revenue sharing is non-starter.
Absolutely. This is a point you are making, it's a very, very important point actually. But when I turn to the power business, I mean, you see the problems coming to an end anytime soon, because this is a sector which has suffered the most maybe in recent years.
But if you see, this government has done phenomenal job as far as the power sector is concerned. If you see, the power generation has done very well. Coal has been produced very well. I request all the union people of coal, is a national cause. Please produce as much as coal possible. Don't let the employment generate in third country. And there the employment being generated and coal being sent it to here is a cause of nation. And it's amazing, the only one company produce oil in this country. One company produce coal in this country, Coal India. You need 20 companies.
In fact, if I turn to another important topic, which is bad loans, I mean, we are seeing some action on the ground lately, but you think the insolvency and bankruptcy code, do you think it will act as a deterrent when it comes to willful defaulters?
No, it's a system which is existence abroad, and it is very harsh for our country. Because we have several difficulties while we building up our project. Sometimes coal is not available, iron ore is not available, power is not available, land is not available, and we have taken a loan and it just stranded and sit on our head for the circumstances whereby government clearances, lot of other things has taken place. Government should and the bank should rethink.
In fact, steel and power would be a big chunk of the NPAs that we are faced with today.
Yeah, I have not gone into detail, but as far as the bankruptcy law is concerned, I welcome as a broader perspective. So people cannot siphon our hardened money, our poor people's money, which is they deposit into the bank. But overall concept, when it comes to a genuine company who has gone through the suffering, bank should come forward to help them.
When the cause is genuine. But if I look at, for example, the Tata Group, recently they spun off their loss-making European operations, spun it off into a joint venture with ThyssenKrupp. I mean, how do you see this merger play out in the global pecking order? Because you are very much a stalwart there when it comes to metal companies.
But you know, this is, in India, we take a lot of time in deciding things.
Even this took a very long time actually.
Yeah, but now I really appreciate what Tata Group is doing to remain as a core competence, to clean up what they need to do and not to waste time. So I don't have a detail, but I really, the way the Tata Group, if you see last 6 months, the way the market has responded them, the way our friend Mr. Chandrasekhar is performing, I really appreciate and I wish them all the best.
In fact, turning to Anglo-American, I mean, you've recently hiked your stake. I mean, you're the largest shareholder today. What's your plan with Anglo-American and whether Vedanta will come into play at some point later?
Of course. I personally hold 21% of the company.
Yeah.
And today I can say with the Anglo-American stake and Vedanta, by and large, there is nothing which between Anglo-American and Vedanta don't produce.
Yeah.
Whether it's a coal, whether it's a diamond, whether it's iron ore, whether it's a copper, zinc, oil and gas, anything and everything below the ground we produce. India does not have a technology. India does not have a mining culture. It does not have a resource culture. So I wish for my country that Anglo-American 100 years old company, the one of the best, finest company in the world, how can I help win-win? I'm talking hypothetically, I'm talking as a philosophy that if they want to come to India and extend their business, I will support them. You know, they are the largest producer of diamond. India, if you see the Kohinoor, it's come from India. We have a Kolar, which is the largest gold mine in the world.
Any plans to get into gold mining with Deccan Gold, that company that has been talked about?
Not at all. It's not our business. It's not our business. We think very different.
I'm sure.
We think very different. Something has to add to my balance sheet. But gold is a phenomenal growth in India. You know, India should produce 1,000 ton of gold. India should produce 1 million ton of copper. India should produce 3 million barrel of oil and 1 million barrel equivalent to the gas. These are very short term. India should produce 700 million ton of iron ore. India should produce at least 200 million ton of extra coal. And this all can happen in 3 years. And if that happen, there will be 20 crore population can be involved. Because everything to be required to be processed. Everything required to be processed. And hardened $400 billion money which goes outside India will remain here. And the job which has been being created for these things which we are importing will be created here. And this does not require much because resources are there. We have to accept the environmental policy. Government has to take it as a first priority. And at least 100 companies to be involved in this sector.
In fact, it's been a fabulous journey for you, the way you build the company, the way you, expanded it, and in a scale which only you can dream of. But the point is, look, going forward, what about succession planning, Gen Next coming into the business? What are your views on that, when it comes to the Vedanta Group?
It's a too large a company. I'm still on the saddle. My children, very ambitious, very good, but I will leave them open. They should build their own big business, what they're looking at. My son, he's doing some medical business in the Chennai. He's looking something in Ghana and he's cleaning up his hand and they should feel fulfillment. Succession, I will be looking at a succession where the most competent people to run this company and this
run
company
by professionals.
Doesn't matter. I'm also a professional.
Absolutely.
Only thing
absolutely.
I have
you have the shareholding capability. Also, yeah.
My shareholder also all
so the best man should run the company, right?
Best man to run the company. My all wealth has been placed for this only to make sure that how can we look and take care of our children. I like to adopt and take care of 50 million children up to the age of 7. I'm looking all the women, at least 20 million children, how can they have entrepreneurial skill? They can have 500 rupees to 1,000 rupees in their hand. I love to do that. And what else you want? We come from Bihar. You know, we have We have grown by the side of Ganges, and we used to take water like this and put it back. So enjoying of taking water is tremendous, but putting back is also very important.
Absolutely. What a fabulous journey it's been. Thank you so much, Mr. Agarwal, for speaking to ETNA. Wish you a fantastic Diwali.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I wish all the viewer and India a very happy, prosperous Diwali. And India should grow many fold. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Agarwal.